So you talked about the negative self-talk. Can you share more about it with our audience? Can you share more about the impact of the negative self-talk on our mental health
Sure.
and how to overcome it?
Sure. The negative self-talk, our brains can only function on one thing at a time. So if we're feeding it all with negative thinking, that's what it's going to go to. It's programmed to think that way. Like the saying says, so shall we think, we will become. And so what I do a lot of work around is challenging faulty belief systems. So with people with anxiety, depression, and OCD, they have a lot of negative thoughts. They're not worthy. They're not worthy of love. They're not worthy of respect. And so I try to put things more from an objective point of view. So I have them write all these thoughts down, and then we start to challenge them. What is the reason? Because I have a, I don't know if you've heard of ACT, where it's a therapy called ACT, and it's the first thing we have to do is awareness. We have to bring awareness to our thoughts, and then we have to bring clarity. And why are we thinking that way? Where does that stem from? And it's interesting because people will minimize their thoughts, but once you start asking the questions and dive a little deeper, there's a lot of layers to it. It may be something that goes back to childhood. They weren't ever told that they could be successful. They were never told. I grew up, nobody ever said, I love you. That was odd. I remember later on in school when I'd go to my friend's house and their parents, when we were leaving to go to school, and their mom would say, I love you. And I'd think, ooh, that sounds like, what does that mean? Like I didn't know what it was. So and then when you go get older and you start to get into relationships, it's interesting what you'll tolerate because you're not putting any demands or expectations on you first to have self-love. Therefore, how if you can't give it to yourself, then how can you ever take it from someone else, right? So it's a real it's it takes time, and even journaling and doing gratitude logs. I have a gratitude book here that every day I do at least a minimum of three things I'm grateful for. A lot of times I have more than them. Even when negative things happen in my day, I tell myself that I'm grateful that I was able to experience that. But more importantly, what am I going to do about it? You know, a lot of times, even in the negative things that happen, we can learn. There's lessons in even negative things that happen to us. So having a gratitude log, journaling is so important because when you journal, sometimes I know a lot of times patients will say to me that they're not doing better, or that they're still negative about themselves. But when they look back, even a few days ago, they were able to do things that they haven't done in months. But it's not unless we can point it out to them. They don't see the little things as successes. So we got to celebrate the wins, no matter how small they are.